Hello students and welcome to Devi Mohal Public School. Let's begin in virtual classes of standard 10th science with your teacher Mrs. Vandana Ghagre. Today in the lesson electricity we are going to see what is the electric current and the circuit. If you observe the slide clearly, many objects, many drawings are there and all these things are related to the electric current. So let's see what is electric current and what is the electric circuit. Now here are the different terms on these slides which are related with the electricity, electric current and the circuit. Just go through each and every word because now in this lesson you are going to familiar with all these words. So what is the electric current and circuit? Electricity is an important place in the modern society. It is a controllable and convenient form of energy from a variety of uses in homes, at school, hospital, industries, and in each and everywhere you can see the many things which are related with the electric current, electricity. So what constitutes this electricity? How does it flows in an electric circuit? From where does this electricity come? What are the factors that controls or regulate the current through the electric circuit? So all these questions might become in your mind when you study, when you come across the word electricity. So in this chapter, we shall attempt to answer these questions. We shall also discuss the heating effect of electric current and its applications, means where we can use the heating effect of the electric current. So different appliances which works on the principle of electric current. Now electric current in circuit, we are familiar with the air current and water current. We know that flowing water constitutes water current in the river. Similarly, if the electric charge flows through a conductor, for example through a metallic conductor, we say that there is an electric current in the conductor. Conductor means which carries the electric current. In a torch, we know that the cell, which you call a battery, when placed in a proper order means we have to check whether it is the plus or minus written on that battery and whether it is put properly in that circuit, that space or not. Provide flow of charges or an electric current through the torch, bulb to globe. If you will place it properly, the bulb will glow. But if you will place it in the disorder, the bulb will not glow. We have also seen that the torch gives light only when its switch is on. So what is the use of switch? Switch is on means what? So what does the switch do actually? A switch makes a conducting link between the cell and the bulb. So when you switch off the switch, the link between conducting cell and bulb broke and hence the bulb will not glow. A continuous and closed path of an electric current called the electric circuit. And this continuous and closed path breaks by the switch. That position is called the on and off. Now if the circuit is broken anywhere or the switch of the torch is turned off, the current stops flowing from the cell to the bulb and the bulb does not glow. How do we express electric current? So electric current is actually expressed by the amount of charge flowing through a particular area in a unit time. It may be hour, it may be second, or it may be 1 minute. In other words, it is actually the rate of flow of electric charges. In the circuits using metallic wires, electrons constitutes the flow of charges. However, electrons were not known at the time when the phenomena of electricity was first observed, because electrons were discovered later on and electricity discovered the first. So the electric current was considered to be the flow of positive charges, and the direction of flow of positive charges was taken to be the direction of electric current. So the positive to negative is actually the direction of the electric current. Conventionally, in an electric circuit, the direction of electric current is taken as opposite to the direction of the flow of electrons, which are the negative charges. We all are aware electrons which are in the conductors are of negative charges. So the direction of the electric current is opposite to the direction of the electrons. Now if a net charge Q flows across any cross section of a conductor in the time t, then the current I through the cross section is I is equal to Q upon t. So this is the formula through which, with the use of which, we can calculate the electric current or charge or the time taken to flow the electric current. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb, that is represented by C, which is equivalent to the charge contained in nearly 6×10⁸ electrons. We know that the electron possesses a negative charge. It is the charge of the negative charge of electron, that equals to 1 electron equals to 1.6×10⁻¹⁹ C. The electric current is expressed by a unit called ampere. As different physical quantities have different units, so here the current, electric current, the unit is called ampere, and it is represented, it is denoted by capital A, named after the French scientist Henri Marie Ampere, 1775-1836. Now 1 ampere is constituted by the flow of 1 coulomb of charge per second. Means for 1 second 1 coulomb of charge is flowing, then it is called the 1 ampere. That is 1 ampere equals to 1 coulomb upon 1 second. Small quantities of current are expressed in milliampere. See the relation between milliampere and ampere. 1 milliampere equals to 10⁻³ ampere or microampere, which is denoted by 1 mu A. That symbol is reading as mu A equals to 10⁻⁶ ampere. So these are the small quantities, small units in which the current is expressed. Now here is the systematic diagram of an electric circuit which contains cell, electric bulb, emitter and plug key. So here the plug key act as a switch. If you in plug, the current electric bulb glows, and if you take out the plug key, then the circuit breaks and the current doesn't flow from cell to bulb and the bulb will not glow. So to complete the electric circuit, we have to put the plug key in. Now an instrument called emitter measures electric current in a circuit. It is always connected in series, means in the line in a circuit through which the current is to be measured. Figure shows the schematic diagram of typical electric circuit comprising a cell, an electric bulb, an emitter and a plug key. Now the electric current flows in a circuit from positive terminal of the cell to the negative terminal of the cell through the bulb and the emitter. So this is all about the electric circuit. Now a small example. A current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by the filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. So here first we will write what is given here. So electric current is given. So write it that as A, I equals to 0.5 A. Time t is given 10 minutes. Convert that time into 6 seconds. So it is 600 seconds. And then the equation is I is equal to Q upon t. Here we want the electric charge. So Q equals to I into t. multiply it, you will get the answer 300 C. So the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit is 300 coulomb. In this way, with the use of different quantities, you can solve what is there to solve. Means it may be charge, it may be electric current, or it may be time that you have to calculate, but the question formula is same. So today we have learnt about the electric circuit and current, and I hope you might have clear ideas and better comprehension of the topic. I explain all the points in detail. Here is a small assignment for you that would help you to check your understanding. So dear students, I hope you would try honestly to solve the assignment. Thank you. Have a nice day.